Hello, this video is an introduction to fractions. The goals of this video are to understand the concept of a fraction and also to state what fraction a model represents. All of us have an intuitive understanding of fractions. For example, if a group of your friends go out for pizza and you plan on eating, at some point you will take one piece of pizza and then you will eat it. Well, this one piece of pizza that you've taken represents a fraction of the whole pizza. And since the pizza was divided into 8 equal parts, and you have one of them, this would be a model for 1/8 of the pizza. A fraction or fractional number is used to represent a part of a whole. Fractions consist of two numbers, a numerator, which is above the fraction bar, and a denominator, which is below the fraction bar. The denominator tells you the number of equal parts into which something is divided, while the numerator tells you how many of these equal parts are being considered. So, for example, this fraction 2/5, notice how the circle is divided into 5 equal parts, with 2 of them being shaded. Over here we have 3/8, where we have divided into 8 equal parts, again, 3 of them shaded. I'd like to take a look at this idea a little bit more. I'm going to visit one of these two websites. You might want to pause the video and jot these down. Now, what this tool allows us to do is it allows us to choose our numerator and denominator, and then this will model a fraction over here on the right. So, for example, if I have a numerator of 1, notice it's just one big piece, but if I change it to 2, 3, and 4, it divides that circle into that number of equal parts. Now if I go to the numerator and increase this, it's going to change the number of pieces that are shaded. So there's 1/4, 2/4, 3/4, and so on. One thing I want you to notice is when I change it to 4/4, of course that's the same as one whole. 4 equal pieces considering all 4 of them. And in fact I can consider more than 4, but what happens is as soon as I increase it past 4, of course it's going to be greater than 1. And it can continue this pattern indefinitely. So for example, if I have 13/4, notice that one whole is divided into 4 equal parts. If I want to consider 13 of them, it's going to be greater than 3. In fact, it will be 3 1/4. I would encourage you to spend some time playing around with this. It really does help develop the idea of how fractions work. Let's see if we can model the fractions that are presented. This first one, we have a circle divided into 8 equal parts. So our denominator, of course, would be 8. And the number of pieces shaded would be 4. Another idea we would consider very soon, we can see that 4/8 is equivalent to 1/2. Number 2, one circle is divided into 5 equal parts. Our denominator is 5. And the number of shaded pieces, we have 5 here and then 3 more, so a total of 8/5. Again, you may have thought of this as 1 3/5. That would be a mixed number, which we will discuss shortly as well. But for right now, we'll leave it as 8/5. Here's some additional information about fractions that we should be aware of. Fractions like 1/3 are not integers. They are rational numbers. Rational numbers consist of all the numbers that can be represented in the form of a over b, where b does not equal 0. So if you can write it as a fraction, where the denominator is not equal to 0, it would be considered a rational number. Number 2, the fraction n over n is equal to 1 for any integer n not equal to 0. Again, we illustrated that earlier, but what that is saying is, if my numerator and denominator are equal, it's going to be equal to 1. That should make sense. If I have a circle that's divided into 3 equal parts, and I consider 3 of them, I would have a complete circle, or 1. Number 3, the fraction 0 over n is equal to 0 for any integer n not equal to 0. Again, that's fairly logical. If I have 3 pieces, but I consider 0 of them, of course that would be 0. One thing I'd like to point out here, a fraction bar is another way to write division. So 0/3 represents the same thing as 0 divided by 3, which again, of course, is 0. This idea, again, will come up soon. Two more. Fractions less than 1 are often called proper fractions. So, for example, 1/3, 2/5, 11/15, and so on. Those are all considered proper fractions because the numerator is less than the denominator. Number 5. Fractions equal to or greater than 1 are often called improper fractions. So if my denominator is 5 and I have a numerator of, let's say, 7, that would be considered an improper fraction, which would be greater than 1. We should also note that if the numerator and denominator are equal, if I have 8 eighths, that is also considered an improper fraction. I'd like to leave you with some interesting statistics involving fractions. Almost half of the dogs in the United States sleep in a family member's bed. Americans throw away 1/4 of the 350 million pounds of food they purchased each year. Number 3, the U.S. has 1/20 of the world's population and produces 3/10 of the world's waste. The United States is responsible for almost 1/4 of the world's energy consumption. We use approximately 1 million gallons of oil every 2 minutes. Thank you for tuning in.